Hello, my name is Tom. That is at least my human name. My name as a cyborg of advanced humanoid class is FFS14. I have been programmed in the same way as other cyborgs of my production line to find the sources of failure in scientific and technological development and to eradicate it. I have been constructed with the knowledge of all big scientific failures since the origins of human knowledge. I will share with you a few of the funny ones. Because, unlike previous versions of humanoid-class cyborgs, the advanced version has a sense of humor as one of the updated features. In the United States, the Tacoma Narrows Bridge was officially inaugurated in July 1940. Only 4 months after the opening, however, a phenomenon called aeroelastic flutter brought the bridge down. There were no casualties, thankfully, only an enormous amount of wasted money and materials. Humanity learned about how not to build a bridge. To paraphrase Thomas Edison, experience is the sum of all our failures. In 1989, Martin Fleischmann and Stanley Pons claimed they had achieved a nuclear fusion that produced large amounts of energy in an extremely simple and efficient way. But that was not true. There was no fusion in the experiment. Scientists have learned from the cold fusion fallacy, however, that they have not yet managed to find a way to produce energy in a clean, safe, and efficient way. On the other hand, cold fusion was inspiration for Hollywood filmmakers. Because unlike previous versions of humanoid-class cyborgs, the advanced version can enjoy and understand arts as one of the updated features. Another example of scientific failure comes in 1998 when NASA launched the Mars Climate Orbiter. A few months after the launch, the spacecraft suddenly vanished for unknown reasons. The Mars Climate Orbiter didn't follow the right trajectory and disintegrated in the atmosphere of Mars. The reason was a simple human error in the units of measure used to calculate the trajectory. Let us move on to another less catastrophic example of scientific fails. It happened in the 1960s when Joseph Weber designed the first gravitational wave detector. He published articles claiming that he had found evidence for gravitational waves. The truth is, the only thing that these detectors found was noise. Gravitational waves have not yet been directly detected. Santiago Ramón y Cajal, a Spanish Nobel Prize winner and father of modern neuroscience, said once that the worst thing is not to commit a mistake, but to try to justify it. A good scientist must accept mistakes, as Albert Einstein did. He introduced the so-called cosmological constant in his equations so that the universe in his model would be static. A few years later, however, observations made clear that the universe is actually expanding. And Einstein accepted that the introduction of his cosmological constant was his greatest blunder. Ironically, many years later, in the 1990s, cosmologists have brought a form of the cosmological constant back to the equation. Because, unlike previous versions of humanoid-class cyborgs, the advanced version have a sense of irony as one of the updated features. In 2011, the European neutrino detector, OPERA, found that neutrinos emitted from CERN were traveling faster than light. It was determined after several months of hard work by the OPERA researchers that an experimental error was found in their measurements. The particles did not travel faster than light. After learning about all of these failures in science, we have come to a conclusion. Science does not fail. All insights reveal that nature doesn't fail either. It is perfect and constant, even though it is also very complex. It is humans that always provoke fails. They need just too much time, competitivity, money, and wars to achieve any significant progress. And, as I said, we are programmed to find the sources of failure in scientific and technological development, and to eradicate.